Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to the class where we discuss TCS specific statistics questions, which is important for last year BE and BCA students who are planning a TCS NQT exam. So you can see this question. You can see this question for the data given below. So this is the class interval with frequency. If you observe this data, this data is in the form of less than class interval with less than cumulative frequency, guys. So you can watch my videos on statistics if you don't understand what is less than class interval with less than cumulative frequency. So this data is there in the form of less than class interval with less than cumulative frequency. So this is less than, below, or less than, synonyms of same thing, below. So this is below 10, this is below 10. So cumulative frequency is 5, then below 20, cumulative frequency is 16, below 30, the cumulative frequency is 28, below 40, the cumulative frequency is 42, and then below 50, cumulative frequency is 72, below 50, the cumulative frequency is 72. Okay, so now what I can do, I can make a normal class interval with normal frequency. So how will you convert the less than class interval with less than cumulative frequency with normal class interval with normal frequency with below or with less than? Always upper limit is given, with more than always a lower limit is given. You can see the class size is 10, 10, 10, 10. Okay, so you can understand this is the upper limit. So this will be 0 to 10, 10 to 20, then 20 to 30, then 30 to 40, then 40 to 50. Cumulative frequency will be 5, 16 minus 5, 11, then 28 minus 16, this would be 12, 42 minus 28, that would be 14, 14 plus 28, 42, and this would be 7. This would be 30. Total sum will be 72. Okay. Once you are aware about this, so if X is the class mark of the model class, what would be the model class? Model class means mode. Mode. What is mode? Mode is the value which repeat the maximum. Okay. Mode is the value which repeat the maximum. So out of these frequency, where are you seeing the mode? Where you see mode can happen? Mode is this only. Mode will be between. You can see that mode would be between 30 to, or for, mode would be between 40 to 50. So if X is the class mark of modal class, what is class mark? Upper limit plus lower limit divided by 2. So what is the class mark? What is the class mark of the modal class? So the class mark of modal class is 40 plus 50 divided by 2 means 45. That is X. And Y is the upper limit of median. Where the median will lie, guys? Where the median will lie? I told you, I have taught you all this thing. So for median, what you will do? The median, the first step is sum of F by 2. Means 72 by 2 you will do. 72 by 2 means 36. See the next value in less than cumulative frequency table, the value bigger than 36. Value bigger than 36 means this is the value. This is the range what you should look for. This is the range what you should look for. So here the median will lie. Here is the range where the median will lie. So what is Y? Y is the upper limit of median class. What is the upper limit of median class? That is 50. Can you understand this? So if you don't know, then you watch my video on median calculation, mode calculation. Step by step, we have discussed everything. Now, if I ask you, what is 2x plus y? 2 into 45 plus 40. This is 90 plus 40, 130. That is your answer. Can you understand, right? The concept of mode, median, mean, whatever you know, so the same thing is being presented in different way. Median formula, when you have class interval with frequency, the formula is L plus H by F into sum of F by 2 minus CF. All that formula, why should we discuss? There's a separate video I have made on this where you can understand how to calculate mode, median and all. Okay, mode is all about the value which repeat the maximum. So the frequency which repeat the maximum, we call that as F1. One frequency before it, we call it F0. One frequency below it, we call it F2. I hope you remember. Yes or no? You remember, right? We did all that. Mode, if you have class interval with frequency L plus F, F1 minus F0 divided by 2F1 minus F0 minus F2. Median, when you have class interval with frequency L plus H by F, sum of F by 2 minus CF. This is a formula for median. So you don't need actually this formula and all. So they don't expect you to find the values. They just want you, they just want you to use the application. I hope you're understanding. So, I'll repeat again. If you want me to repeat it again, see, this is less than, guys, if you understand, if you see this class interval and frequency, this is less than class interval with less than cumulative frequency. If you want more discussion on this, I'll forward you a couple of videos on cumulative frequency and all, but you have to understand this part, guys. So if below word means it is less than, okay. So below, with below, the number what is written, that is the upper limit. So it is below 10, below 20, below 30, below 40, below 50, means they are the upper limit. And if you see the difference is 10. It means their class size is 10. Their class size is 10. And you can see the upper limit as 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. So if I know the class size is 10, and if I know the upper limit is 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, I can find the lower limit. So I can find the class interval. Okay, then these are the cumulative frequency given. I can find the normal frequency. So how will you find the normal frequency from the cumulative frequency? How will you find the normal frequency? This is 16 minus 5. This is 28 minus 16. This is 42 minus 28. This is 72 minus 42. Can you understand this? So once you get the normal frequency, once you get the normal class interval, then how will you determine the mode? Here, how will you determine the mode? How will you work on mode? Once you get the normal class interval with normal frequency, how you can work on mode? Mode is that frequency which repeat the maximum. So which frequency is repeated the maximum? 40. So means your mode will lie here between what? 40 to 50. So 30 is F1, 14 is F0, and there's no frequency below it. So F2 is 0. So your modal class interval is 40 to 50. Can you understand this? Your modal class interval is 40 to 50. Can you understand this? If your modal class interval is 40 to 50, your class mark is lower limit plus upper limit by 2. So your X value 40 plus 50 divided by 2, that would be 45. Is this clear? Okay, fair. Then if I talk of median, how we do median calculation, just revise, think how I taught you the median calculation. How we do median calculation, guys? For the median calculation, what is required? Your data should be in the form of less than cumulative frequency. That is already given in the problem only. So we don't have to do hard work doing that. That was already given in the problem. So what we do, once your data is in the form of less than cumulative frequency for median, for the calculation of median, we find sum of F by 2. Sum of F is 72. 72 by 2 is 36. Okay. Then what we used to do, I hope please remember what I have taught you. Once you get the sum of F by 2, then what we used to do, check in less than cumulative frequency table. We check in less than cumulative frequency table, the next value bigger than sum of F by 2. Check in less than cumulative frequency table and there find the next value, find the next value. Okay, find the next value bigger than sum of f by 2. The next value which is bigger than 36 is 42. That means your median will lie between this 30 to 40. That means your median will lie in 30 to 40. So they are not interested in median. They just want the what is the upper limit of the median class. So the upper limit of median class is 40. And then you have to find this value. Okay. Then we'll only focus on teachers statistics questions. This is all profit and loss, this train problem and all, I'm not discussing. If you want, I have separate video, I'll watch, give them. Right now, we are not concerned to do them. So now see this problem number 6, the statistics problem. Let X is the median of the data. X is the median of this data. Okay, X is the median data. If 16 and 23 are replaced by 30 and 32, then Y is the resulting, Y is the median resulting data. So what is the value? So first I'll find the median of this data. So for the median, what you do for median calculation, what you do, you will arrange the data in ascending order. So then only I'll get the X. You'll arrange the data in ascending order. You'll arrange the data in ascending order. So if you arrange the data in ascending order, so the smallest value is 9. Okay, the smallest value is 9, then 16, 15, let me know, 15, then 16, okay, 15, 16, then 23, then 20, then 23, 20, then count the term 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12. Okay, if 12 terms are there, then how will you find the median? Median formula is n plus 1 by second observation. So if you have 12 terms, so the median would be 12 terms, the median would be 12 plus 1, 13, 13 by 2 means 6.5th observation. 6.5th observation means 6 plus 7 divided by 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6.5 means 27 would be the median. 26 plus 28 divided by 2. Okay. So then what they're asking you, if 16 is replaced by 30, if 16 is replaced by 30 and 23 by 32, now you don't have 16 and 23. Now if you don't have 16 and 23, Now, if you don't have 16, now you don't have 16 and 23. Now you don't have 16. Now you don't have 16 and 23. So you don't have 16 and 23. So 9, 5, 9, 15, 20. Okay, then 20, then 26, then 28. 28 and then 30. And then you have 2 to 32. 2 to 32. Okay, then 33, 34, 35. And 43. Again 12 numbers. So again the median would be 6.5th observation. 6.5th observation is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So now your median would be 31. Now the median would be 31. So x is 27. It means x is 27 and y is 31. Okay, so what is the value of 3x minus 2y? 3 into 27 minus 2 into 31. So this is 81 minus 62. That would be 90. Anyone, any doubt? Clear this? Any doubt, anyone? Now see this 15th problem. So you can see this, guys, different exams and all, they're asking you questions based on mean, median, mode, the basic concepts of what you are studying in your BCA. So all the semesters, all the subjects, what you are studying is very important. Okay, I'm showing you the future. So 2 years down the line, when you sit for placements, then you will get these kind of questions. So are you really prepared for that? Will you able to remember what Amit sir has taught you 2 years back? So that matters a lot. So how much effort I'm doing from my end, but then how much effort you are doing to make sure you remember, that matters the most. What is the mean of the mode of median or mode and median of the data? So here, if you see, you have x and then you have f. Better arrange in ascending order. Now that could do the best thing. Arrange in ascending order. So 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, comma 1, 1 comma 1, 1, 1, then 2, how many times? Only once 2, okay, then 3, 1, 2, 3 times 2, okay, then 4, 1, 2, 4, 2 times, then 5, 1, 2, 5, 2 times, 5 to 10, then 6, 6, 1, 2, 3. I think 6 is the most, 6 3 times, then 7, 1, 2, 7, 2 times, and then 8, 1, 2, 8, 2 times, and then 9, 1, 2, 9, 2 times. Count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. So your mode is 6. You know that your mode is 6. Because mode 6 will be the maximum time. Now median, 18 number, na? 18. 18 plus 1, 19. 19 by 2 means... 19 by 2 means what? 9.5, no? 9.5. 9.5 means 9 plus 10 divided by 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. So the median would be 5 plus 6 divided by 2. So median would be 5.5. Okay, so what is the mean? They ask me the mean of mean and mode and median. What is the mean of mode and median? 6 plus 5.5 by 2 is 11.5 by 2, 5.75. Any doubt, anyone? Now this is the question on standard deviation. Standard deviation I have not taught you. Just for this question, I'll do this. Easy only, not a difficult thing. So we'll do standard deviation. Okay, how to find the standard deviation? When we talk about standard deviation, I'll teach you in future standard deviation. The standard deviation, the symbol to represent standard deviation is sigma. This is the symbol to represent standard deviation. You heard of Six Sigma certifications and all. So that basically talks about this only. Standard deviation, it is a measurement of risk. Risk is the deviation between expected and actual. And the formula for standard deviation, when you say standard deviation, the formula for standard deviation is under root of summation of x minus x bar whole square by n. This is one formula. Or you can use another formula of standard deviation, summation of x square by n minus x bar square. This is another formula of standard deviation. So you can use any formula. And with this formula, you can find the standard deviation. So basically, standard deviation, the formula, what you're seeing, actually, there's a formula to work on standard deviation when raw data is given. So when you have class interval with frequency, then the formula would be different. But right now, we are not that much, very much interested to solve or understand that formula for the time being for solving this question. For solving this question, either you can solve this question by using this formula, or this formula, you'll get the same answer. Okay, what is x bar here? X bar basically means average. If nothing is given, you'll take x bar as a mean. Okay, if nothing is given, you'll take x bar as a mean, means sum of data divided by number of data. Clear, right? So now what I'll do, I'll try to solve the question. You have 5, you have 7, you have 9, you have 11, then you have 13, 7, 11, 13, then you have 16, then you have 17. Then 18, 19, 35, okay, so you have this, so this data are given to you, okay. So this data is given to you, for this data, you have to find the standard deviation, so find x square, 25, 49, 81, 121, 169, then 256, then 289, then 324, then 361, then 1225. So you find this x squared, then do the sum of this. You can do the sum of this. What is the sum of this? Find the sum of this. Okay, do the sum of this. So 9 plus 1, 10, 15, 16, 25, 31, 40, 44, 45, 50. 5 carry, 5 plus 2, 7, 7 plus 4, 11, 19, 21, 27, 32, 40, 42, 48, 50. 5 carry, 5, 6, 7, 9, 11, 14, 17, 19, 1 carry, 1 carry, this is 2900 you'll get, 2900 you'll get, that is the sum of x square, okay, and here I can find the mean also, sum of x is what, 5, 5, 5, 10, then 17, 17, 26, 27, 30, 36, 36, 43, 51, 51, 60, 6 carry, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 150, sum of x is 150. So the mean would be 150 by how much number? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So the mean is 15. Sum of x square is 2900. So the standard deviation. So the standard deviation is under root of sum of x square by n minus x bar square. The standard deviation is 2900 by 10 minus mean. Mean was 15 per square. So then your standard deviation was 290 minus 225. So this was 65, under root of 65. That would be your standard deviation. So, and you know that under root of 64 means 8. So your answer will be 8 point something. If you want the exact value, I can tell you 8 point something. Square root of 65 also you want, I will tell you square root of 65. This is all you get in schooling. 100 means 161 will be 0. This is 100. Then 169, it will go by 8.09 something. 8.09 will be answer. So you can see this. This is answer is option A. Clear anyone? Anyone have any doubt? I use the formula for standard deviation. Which formula I used? So I use this formula for standard deviation. Any doubt, anyone? Fine. I hope you understood this. This was question number 20. I think maximum 20 questions are there. So you had 20 questions here. Now tell me this question number one. So if you see this question number one, you have class intervals. You have class intervals 0 to 8, 8 to 16, then 16 to 24, then 24 to 32 like this, then 32 to 30, what? 32 to 40 like this. Now the question comes, if suppose there's a value called 24, if there's a value called 24, that 24 will come where? Will it come in this class interval or will it come in this class interval? So this is a very important question. So because they are continuous class interval, imagine if there's a value called 8, if there's a frequency 7, it will come in 0 to 8. There's no doubt. If there's a frequency 9, then it will come into 8 to 16. There's no doubt. But if there's a frequency, there's a value called 8, will it come here or will it come here? Always remember, 0 to 8 means all the values less than 8. Oh, okay, so you understand. So all the values that are less than 8 will come here. Any value which is equal to 8 or more than 8, but less than 16 will come here. Similarly, so 24 will come in this class interval, 24 to 32. Please understand. Any doubt, anyone? Okay, then you see the second question. Tell me the answer, second one. The class mark, what is class mark? Class mark means lower limit plus upper limit divided by 2. So the class mark is 17.5, means lower limit plus upper limit divided by 2 is 17.5. Matlab lower limit plus upper limit is 35. That is one equation. Lower limit plus upper limit 35, that is one equation. Class size is 5, means upper limit minus lower limit is 5. I hope you understand the meaning of the class size. Class size is the difference between lower limit and upper limit. So class size is 5. Okay, and the upper limit plus lower limit is 35. So if I add them, I can say 2u is equal to 40, means u is equal to 20. Means the upper limit is 20. Very good, Megha. Do the third one. third one, the class mark of the distribution. Sorry, class mark of the distribution are, so class mark of the distribution are this, they given you this. So what is the class size? Class size would be 10. You can see the difference. The difference is 10, 10, 10. Now see this, if you get this like question number 4 kind of question, so the population of 4 towns A, B, C, D are given. So which is the most appropriate diagram to present the above data? You can see if you have jumbled data or you have unstructured data, if you have unstructured data or irregular data, better word would be if you have irregular data, if you have irregular data like this. Okay, so the best way to represent them is bar chart. Okay, just remember the theory question. Then do this question number 5. So you theoretically you can understand this, guys. Whatever changes you make on your individual values, the same impact will happen on mean. If mean was earlier x bar, and if every number you are adding with a minus b, then mean will be also added by a minus b. If you subtract every value, each number by something, mean will be impacted by the same thing. It's a concept which you should know. If you want to prove, I can prove it also. If you say, sir, you prove it, we can prove it also. So x bar is equal to x1 plus x2 plus x3 till xn divided by n. So I can write x1 plus x2 plus x3 is equal to n x bar. Okay, now if all are added by a minus b, if I add all by a minus b, you know that. So your x1 plus x2 plus x3 till xn by n, the mean is x bar. So you can say x1 plus x2 plus x3 till xn is equal to n x over bar. This is your first equation. Okay, then if each number is added by a minus b, if each number is added by a minus b, if you add a minus b to each number, if you add a minus b, if you add a minus b to each number, you add a minus b. You add a minus b to each number. Okay, so what would be the mean of this? Mean of them. So the mean of them, it would be nothing but x1 plus x2 plus x3 till xn. Plus each number you added n, so n into a minus b divided by n. So this set of number you can write as n x over bar plus n a minus b by n. So ultimately this will give you the answer called x bar plus a minus b. That is your final answer. Answer is option D. Calculate the mean of weekly data from a frequency distribution. I hope everyone can do these kind of questions, right? Whenever you have class interval with frequency, you can use the formula sum of fx by sum of f. X, you will get, x is what, mid value. That is 35, 45, 55, 65, 75, 85. If you want, you can use step deviation method. Okay, to find the value of D, you can find the value of D, or you can multiply F into X, whatever is okay with you. You apply that, find the sum of FX divided by sum of F. I'll forward you Mega these questions. So if you want, I'll forward you. You can solve these questions. Okay, so you can very easy to solve. So how will you do this question number 7? All these questions you can try. The observation 29, 32, 48, 50, x, x plus 2, 70, 78, 84, 95. They arrange in ascending order. What is the value of x if the median is 63? You can easily solve them. Easily if you want. You can solve them. So these are the observations. They already arranged in ascending order. So for median, what you need n. Once the data is in ascending order, what you need in median, you need n. So what is n? N is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. N is 10. 1 minute. So, n is 10, then how will you find a median? Median, you can use a formula. Median, you can use the formula n plus 1 by second observation. Second observation, you can use this formula. So your median would be 11 by 2, means 5.5th observation. I hope you understand it. Median. N is 10, so 10 plus 1, 11, 11 by 2 means 5.5th observation, that is a median. So 5.5th observation means, what is 5.5th observation? That is 5th observation plus 6th observation divided by 2. That means, no, 5.5th observation. What is 5.5th observation? This is 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th and 6th. So means x plus x by 2. Divide by 2, and that is equal to median. Median is given to you 63. Median of the data is 63. So you can solve this. So this is 2x plus 2 is equal to 126. 2x is equal to 124. So x is equal to 62. So that is the value of x. Clear everyone? So like this you can solve this question. I'll send you these questions. You solve these questions. You can solve these questions. So I have a lot of questions based on this. You can solve this question. If you have any doubt in any questions, you let me know. I'll help you with this. Around 26 questions are there. If you want, I'll forward you these questions. You can practice this question. It will helpful for you. You understood, right? What all we have done so far. Okay guys, so I hope you have understood. Any question, anyone? Anything you want to ask from me? I'll forward you the remaining questions. You can practice those questions. You can just do that. Whatever I have taught you, based on that only, the different companies ask in the interview process. Solving them will not be a big thing for you. So please solve them. Let me know if you have any doubt, any concern. So can we wind up the class, guys, then? Thank you, everyone. I'll see you all tomorrow.